Hello and welcome back to another Classic WoW video. Today we will cover level 19 Twinking and go through the best in slot gear and talent points for every single class. We'll go through Twinking in general and then we'll talk about each class specifically. This guide is based on the official WoWhead's Classics Guide to Twinking in Classic WoW, plus a thread I found on Reddit. I'll leave a link to the Classic WoWhead guide in the description, just in case you want a text format to follow, as it has most of the same information as is in this video. First off, when it comes to Twinking, there are a few things you should know. First off, it requires a lot of grinding if you want to have the best gear and items possible, and that takes a long time. It can also take some trial and error, as you want to eliminate the opportunity of getting experience later on, as early as possible. For example, some quest chains you need to do to acquire best in slot items or two can only be started at level 18 or 19, and it will yield quite a bit of experience, so you will be close to hitting level 20, which will ruin the whole level 19 Twink character. So for example, if you explore a few too many zones while having a maxed out Twink character, you might get too much experience and accidentally level up. There is one simple way to eliminate this, which is to fully explore every single zone you think you'll ever go to as a level 19 Twink as early as possible. Go there as level 10 and just explore for a level or two until you've finally or fully explored the zones you might want to go to once you're level 19. One thing is you should always explore more than you have to, just to be sure. This can be tedious, but it's something you'll have to do. After this, you'll also want to farm Timbermaw Hold Reputation for the Firbolg Medicine Pouch for some insanely strong self-healing. Obviously, you can't kill these mobs yourself, so you'll need a friend or you have to pay someone to help you farm Reputation. This item is absolutely vital for Twinks to have, as it's a strong self-healing item meant for level 40 plus people, but can be used by anyone. You also get a headpiece and shoes with insane stamina that can be used by some level 19 Twinks, and are in fact best in slot for quite a few, and you get those items from fishing in Stranglethorn Vale during the Stranglethorn Fishing Extravaganza, so you need to go to Stranglethorn Vale and explore that zone before hitting level 19. You will also need the Arena Master Trinket from the PvP chest in Stranglethorn. Good luck with that one. Now before I move on to talking about character-specific best in slot items, I would like to mention that some enchants, in fact most of them, are locked behind certain raids and imputations that will be added later in Classic. Some will unlock in the earlier phases, but some enchants are unavailable until Anki-Raj, which comes out in Phase 5 or Phase 6, so that will take a long time. You can, however, use a lesser enchant, which will still be best in slot until a better one comes along in a later phase, but then you'll have to replace that enchant later when that better one comes out, which can be quite expensive. Alright, time to move on to the class-specific best in slot items. First off, we have Rogue. The best in slot items for a Rogue are shown in this picture, and you can also see how to acquire them. How to obtain the items are shown in the column to the right, so you can search up on WoWhead if you're unsure on how to complete those quests. Key abilities as a rogue are Ambush, Backstab, Sinister Strike, and Eviscerate. Additionally, you also have Gouge, which, if spec'd correctly, will allow you to pull off a full bandage while the enemy is gouged. Whether you use Ambush and Backstab or Sinister Strike for generating combo points depends on if you use Assassin's Blade or Shadow Fang in your main hand, and if weapon switching during combat is a thing in Classic, it can allow for some really hardcore gameplay and multiple macros for weapon switching functioning, basically like the stance switching for warriors. This could be one way of maximizing damage, and if you can in fact switch between Shadow Fang and Assassin's Blade in the main hand, you can have a one-shot macro by using Dagger for Ambush and Backstab, then switch to Shadow Fang for a Sinister Strike and Eviscerate for as much damage output as possible. The talents you'll want as a level 19 Twink Rogue are dependent on your playstyle, but in general this is the most common build. The best races for rogues are again dependent on your playstyle to a degree, but in general it's gnomes for alliance and undead for horde. This is mostly because of the insanely strong gnome racial to remove CC and movement impairing effects, and undead's racial to prevent fears, charms and sleep effects. Next up, we will talk about warriors. The best in slot items for a warrior are shown in this picture, but it depends on your playstyle. You can switch out the main hand plus shield for a two-hander like Night Reaver or the Glacial Stone. Once again, if weapon switching during combat works in PvP, you can always use sword plus shield to begin with so you can survive a rogue's initial burst if possible, for then to switch to a two-hander when you perform your own burst. Or if you're doing battlegrounds and you have your own personal healer, you can just ignore using shields completely. Here you can see the most common build for level 19 Twink Warriors with 5 points into both parry and crit damage for a bit of survival and a bit of damage output. Key abilities for Warriors are Hamstring for slowing enemies, Heroic Strike for damage, Shield Bash for interrupting, and Sunder Armor to blast through the armor of the enemy. Additionally, you also have abilities like Charge, which grants you some advantages as well. The best races for Warriors when it comes to Twinking is a bit complex, as you can choose to go maximum damage output since certain races will have more sword skill or more axe skill, but in general you want to have as much mobility as possible, so Gnome is still the superior race if you ask me. For Horde, Tauren and Undead are both great. Tauren gets plus 5% HP and a stun effect, which is really good to have, while Undead gives Will of the Forsaken, which is good against fair abilities. Next up we have Hunters. Hunter is a very popular class in the level 19 Twink bracket because you can deal a lot of damage from far away, and you can efficiently kite most targets, and you will melt cloth wearers with physical damage. The best slot hunter items are shown in this picture. As a hunter, your best ability is your auto shot, and weaving your auto shot is key. Therefore, I would recommend downloading an auto shot timer. Additionally, you can use multi-shot, arcane shot, and serpent sting for additional damage as long as you weave it into your auto shot rotation. Concussive shot is also great to use on enemies to kite them or to slow them when they try to run away. On the screen right now you'll see the most common Hunter Twink build with a bit of damage and a bit of defense through the parry talent. You can also choose to go for lethal shot talent in the Markman's ship tree for 1% crit damage, that's up to you. You have a bit of flexibility as a hunter and can pretty much design your own spec and you'll be fine. For Alliance the best Hunter Twink race is Dwarf because of stone form, while for Horde the best race is highly dependent on your gameplay. You can go for Tauren for more survival against rogues, having 5% HP and a stun effect, or you can go Orc for more direct damage through Blood Fury and hardiness against stuns, or you can go Troll for Berserking, which increases attack speed, plus their high base agility, so you have tons of options there. Next up is Priest. Priests are probably the best healers in this bracket due to their power budge shield and ability to both deal a good amount of damage and healing in any spec. Mainly, priests should focus on healing their allies, especially in battlegrounds, but having the ability to deal damage as well is really good in pretty much every PvP scenario, but especially in duels, since they can heal themselves and deal damage to the enemy, both pretty consistently as well. On the screen right now, you can see the best in slot gear for priests and where to acquire it. For most of it, you have best in slot lists for cloth, leather, and mail, and there are very few pieces that change from class to class. Alternatively, you can check for pieces with healing power or shadow spell damage on them, as they might be better if they have a good amount of stats on them. When it comes to talents, I'd say it's pretty flexible, but here you can see the general level 19 Twink Priest build. Priests are looked at as a very strong class, as they're one of few that can survive a rogue's initial burst if they get the opener on you, especially if you can pre-shield yourself before the burst damage comes in. And if you can survive a rogue's initial burst damage, you might be able to outplay him and win in a 1v1 scenario, which not a lot of classes can say in this bracket. I should also mention that Priest Healer plus Hunter DPS is a sick duo for level 19 Twink Battlegrounds, as you'll crush through non-Twink geared people and rack up those honorable kills, since you can both attack from far away and you can just pocket heal the Hunter. Having a rogue that can break through the enemy lines and push them from behind is also good, but not necessary since the Hunter will just bulldoze his way through everything. The best race for priests on Alliance is by far Dwarves, as they have access to Stone Form and Fear Ward, both of which are very strong in this Twink bracket. On Horde side you have two options, Trolls and Undead. Trolls are good because of their Hex of Weakness priest racial ability, which reduces the enemy's damage done and healing received by 20% for a long time. Undead, however, has a pre-strafe ability that on hit causes the enemy to take a little bit of shadow damage and get a debuff that decreases their damage done, which isn't the best racial ability, but undeads do also have access to Will of the Forsaken, which really helps you with Warlocks in a level 19 Twink bracket. Speaking of Warlocks, I think we should talk about Warlock Twinks as well. In this picture you can see the best in slot gear for level 19 Twink Warlocks. Warlocks are also quite strong in this bracket due to their insane crowd control ability called Fear. Sadly, Fear Ward from Priest will kinda make Fear a bit worse than it otherwise would be, and if you're playing Alliance and going into a battleground, you might want to focus Fear on non-undead characters, since undeads will just use Will of the Forsaken to break out of your Fear. Additionally, Warlocks have self-healing through Health Stone, which is really strong, and you can have both damage over time spells and direct damage spells, all of which hit very hard and can melt targets down. I would say Battlegrounds is where Warlocks truly shine, as you can fully dot one target, tab target, and fully dot the next one, and just keep doing that over and over, slowly melting down the entire enemy team. As a Warlock in a battleground, it's your job to get the enemies to low health and constantly apply pressure, so a Rogue or a Hunter can come in and catch those easy kills on the already weakened players. As a Warlock, I'd say that you don't have a lot of flexibility in talent choice, as you want that instant corruption and you want that extra stamina to survive enemy burst damage, and potentially also survive a Rogue's initial burst in a 1v1 scenario. As an Alliance, you want to play Gnome due to their increased intellect and their Escape Artist racial ability, allowing them to break out of movement impairing effects, which can be very strong against melees that stun or slow you. As a Horde, you'll want to be Undead due to the Will of the Forsaken. Next up, we have the Mage class. Mages are a bit unique because they have the opportunity to be a mix of all spell types or focus on one spell type. In this picture you can see the general best in slot gear for a Mage Twink, however if you want to, you can also go full ham on fire damage gear if you can acquire any. This is because at level 18 you get rank 4 Fireball, which with a full fire damage set can hit very hard. If you go the route of fire damage, your main abilities will be rank 1 Frostbolt for the fast cast and the slow effect, then hard casting a fireball. Alternatively, you can frostbolt, then polymorph, then fireball, if you want to have some extra safety. You also have abilities like Frost Nova and Blink to help you get out of dangerous scenarios and help escape from melees. Also, the talent tree setup here is, again, the best one in general, but if you want to go for the fireball tactics, I would advise you to just put 10 points into fire instead. This all depends on the playstyle you want to use, and if you want to survive survival or top DPS, and if you want to have high mobility or be a glass cannon. When it comes to races, it's the same for Mage as it was for Warlocks, so Gnomes for Alliance and Undead for Horde. The next class is Paladins. Here you can see the best in slot setup for Paladins. Paladins are an Alliance only class in Classic, and they can actually be quite good at this bracket due to their mobility and flexibility, being able to escape pretty much anything, survive anything, and kill anything. Being a Retribution Paladin requires clever use of macros and slash ore, fast usage of spells since you can pretty much skip global cooldowns if you use the right seals and such. To know more about Paladins, I would suggest you check out Rex Troy on YouTube, as he has a lot of Paladin specific videos. Regardless, Paladins also have access to abilities like Blessing of Freedom, which lets you escape slow effects, making it really good against, for example, Mages and Warriors. You also have Blessing of Protection and Divine Protection, aka bubbles that make you immune to damage for a short amount of time, during which you can heal up through spells or through bandages. You also have Hammer of Justice, which is really strong as well, and it just adds to your overall flexibility and mobility. Here you can see the talent setup for Twink Paladins, and if you want to, you can switch the 3 points in Retribution around if you think you'll get more use from putting them somewhere else, like for example Divine Strength in the Holy Tree for that strength increase. But the 7 points in Protection are absolutely vital, since the 2 points in Row 2 reduces the Blessing of Protection cooldown by 2 minutes, and increases the duration of Hand of Freedom by 6 seconds. This is a talent you absolutely need. When it comes to races for Paladins, Dwarves are the best choice due to Stone Form. Paladins are a really strong and somewhat undervalued class as level 19 twinks, since I never really saw too many of them myself back in the day, or when I was twinking myself back in Cataclysm on live servers, I mostly saw rogues, hunter and priests. But I do think Paladin can be very good as well, and they are a really strong hybrid class. Next up we have Shamans, and I am going to be completely honest with you, I'm an Alliance main, and I have pretty much always been an Alliance main, except for Mist of Pandaria, and even then when I used to be a Horde main I never really played a Shaman. Regardless, I stole yet another best in slot list from Mauhead, so here you go. I don't expect to see a lot of Shamans in the level 19 twink bracket, but if you do want to give it a go, here's the best gear you'll want to get. Which talents you go for kinda depends on what spec you want to play, but for Elemental, this is the right spec right here. One good thing about Shaman Twinks is their totems. Having access to totems like Earthbind Totem can be really strong against melees, and lets you have some time to cast a spell while kiting. Additionally, you have Earth Shock, which can give you an edge against, for example, mages and warlocks if you can successfully interrupt one of their important casts, and then burst them down while they're silenced, I guess. The only thing I don't like about Shamans is that they have no way of surviving a rogue's burst. Any hunter can kill them easily, and they can't be undead, so warlocks can fear them and then kill them, but they do actually have all the tools they need to survive both melee and ranged players, so I guess it's all up to the individual player's skill. The last class we'll talk about today is Druids. I saved the best for last, just kidding. But yeah, druids can be good, but it depends on what you're doing while twinking. Basically, druids are great hybrids and can function as a DPS, healer, and a tank. This is both their strength and their weakness in this bracket, since they can do everything, but they're not really the best at anything, well, except for flank carrying as a bear due to their armor increase. You can see the best in slot gear for a level 19 druid here. I would also put all of my talent points into the balance tree for Nature's Grasp and Entangling Roots, but that's up to you and your playstyle. But it's worth noting that as a druid, mobility is your friend. There's not much more to say about druids, since only one race per faction can play them, and their main purpose in this bracket is to flag carry. So there it is, my level 19 twink guide for Classic WoW. This guide was meant to quickly highlight each class in the level 19 twink bracket while providing you with the most basic, but important information about that class in the level 19 twink bracket. I want to make videos on each specific class later in Classic, especially Rogue and Hunter, since those are the classes I intend on twinking myself. Let me know if this is something you guys would want to watch, since I feel like I can't go too in-depth on every class in a video like this one, since it would turn into a 1 hour long video. It's important to note that twinking requires a lot of work. You'll want to have max first aid, max engineering, grind high level reputations for strong items, fish in Stranglethorn Vale, do the Stranglethorn Arena, complete specific quest chains to obtain best in slot gear, and it's also quite expensive due to certain best in slot pieces being world drops, and you need to get lucky or buy them from the auction house. You also use endgame enchants, which are quite expensive indeed. I chose not to mention which enchants are best in slot for each specific item slot for each class, as this depends on your role and your playstyle. For example, in one setup, a rogue's best in slot enchants might be Icy Chill to slow enemies, while in a different setup, you want life stealing or plus 15 agility, or maybe even Crusader. You can check out the WoWhead guide that I followed to make this video, which is linked in the description, if you want to see which enchants they recommend. And with all that being said, I do hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure you slap that like button. If you want to see more videos from me, make sure you subscribe, and click that bell button for updates. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.